Taylor is an amazing writer. And having him on board as a screenwriter guarantee you a high level of storytelling, great character development, and straight to the point dialogue that makes everything really fast, brilliant. The plan is pretty scary and simple. Is to kill someone from a cartel and putting, of course, the responsibility on the other one, and mostly kidnapping the daughter of one of the biggest boss of the cartels. That is the guy who gave the order to kill Alejandro's family. So the point is to kidnap the girl and release her in one of the cartels' territories and see what's happened. Matt is a soldier. He works for the government. Means that he has to obey to order. And in our story, in a specific moment, is gonna have to decide if to go against the U.S. government by feeling, by following his moral point of view. But this struggle makes him a soldier, a pure soldier, because he cannot decide. He just has to obey order. Alejandro is a completely different character because he's a lone wolf. He's moved by the rage of searching vengeance for what's happened to his family. And he works for Matt. That's it. So he has just himself as a moral compass. And in our movie, he's gonna use his Sicario skills in, let's say, in a different way. In the beginning, they start again working together. And the reason why they are together probably is because they are good at what they do. And for sure they have, they trust and they like each other. But the issue arises when they meet the little girl and they had to split. And Alejandro had to go and find the girl. I like very much to work with practical effects. I like also VFX, but I feel that more you do practical, the more you have a reaction from the actor. Means that putting an actor where you have a real explosion all around him really helps him in making the performance. So we did an incredible work of prep in this sequence. And then the most complicated part was to shoot almost entirely the scene from inside the AMVI, because we had an incredible amount of effects really close to our actors. I mean, just, you know, aside from his evident acting skills, he's an incredible human being. And as an actor, he has a really great skill that he gets the entire scope of the movie. Means that he knows perfectly where his character is in a moment, but also where all the other characters are. So this gives him a sort of higher point of view that it's pretty rare. To watch Benicio immersing in the character, it's an incredible experience because it's like he enter so completely in the character that everything he does makes sense, not for himself, but for the character. And then I'm talking about small things, small props around him. And this is amazing, the ability he has to build the character. The character is incredible. Isabela, she is a young adult. She's immensely talented and was really nice to have her on set because she's a 16 years old girl. Means that she does, she WhatsApp, she talk at the phone, and then when you say, okay, ready to shoot, she transform herself. And then this is something I've seen really few times in my life. So she can come from, okay, call you, to the perfect concentration. So in a way, she gave to the character exactly what we needed, because it's like Isabela, the character, is an old young. Means that is a young girl that has seen a lot. So I think she gave to the movie an incredible touch, and she's so amazing. I always believe that a movie must entertain you smartly. And also, I feel it's not bad if after the entertain, you think that the movie made you think a bit about the world that is around you. This means that, of course, we explore some really contemporary issue, but not as a documentary do. Is part of the frame. It's part of the background. And it makes the story realistic. By shooting in a location, you're going to feel the authenticity, the reality around you, even with small detail, but I feel they are really, really important. Especially if you work with the story that set it up in a specific place, like Soldado is a story in the border, so it was, of course, impossible not to go there in the desert and shoot in cities really close to the border to get the real feeling of our story and of the truth.